Airbus recently announced they are planning to make these three planes. What is special about them is that these planes are planned to use hydrogen as the fuel source. The reason? Well, hydrogen doesn't have any emissions other than water vapor, which makes it an option for sustainable transport. But what is interesting is that Airbus aims to put these planes into service around 2035, which begs the question if it is even relevant at that time, considering the advancements in battery technology. So, in this video, we will go over whether or not hydrogen is a viable option for planes and other sustainable transport by looking at the upsides and downsides of using this element, and of course compare it to other sustainable options including electric planes. Also, only a small percentage of people who watch my videos are actually subscribed, so if you end up liking this video, consider subscribing, it's free and you can always change your mind. So, before we talk planes, we need to understand how the fuel is created and how it is sustainable. Hydrogen can certainly be sustainable, except for the fact that 95% of the world's supply of hydrogen currently gets produced by steam methane reforming, a method that is super cheap but also emits greenhouse gases. The only way to make sustainable hydrogen is through electrolysis, where you run an electrical current through water to separate the oxygen and hydrogen molecules. Then you dump the oxygen and you are left with the hydrogen. Now, why don't we just create all hydrogen this way? Well, it's actually quite a simple answer: inefficiency and money. So, let's first talk about the inefficiency problem. You see, the thing about this method is that electrolysis requires electricity to produce hydrogen, and that process has an efficiency of around 70 to 80%, depending on what specific method you use. Essentially meaning you lose around 20 to 30% of the energy when you convert electricity to hydrogen using this method. Now you need to use the hydrogen for combustion, which is a stupid idea, but that is what Airbus wants to do, so that is what we will go off of. You only get around a quarter of the hydrogen converted into actual useful energy, since the process is so inefficient, meaning that 75% of the fuel you carry is dead weight and can't be used for anything, which obviously is a problem. So why even consider hydrogen for a plane? Well, the strongest argument and the only valuable argument there is for using it is the higher energy density that it provides. You see, hydrogen has a specific energy of nearly 40,000 watt-hours per kilogram, whereas batteries have energy densities of around 250 watt-hours per kilogram, which is what we see in Tesla's vehicles today. So hydrogen has 160 times more energy density per kilogram than the batteries we have today. So on the surface, hydrogen actually seems like a much better option. But there are a few things you need to consider before you can actually compare the two. First, you need to divide the hydrogen's energy density by 4, because remember, we can only convert 25% of the hydrogen to useful energy. That brings the useful energy from 40,000 to 10,000. Now, hydrogen provides 40 times more energy per kilogram, which is still a quite significant advantage over batteries. But we know that we will have a battery with more than 400 watt-hours per kilogram in energy density in around 3 to 4 years. That means that hydrogen's advantage drops down to 25 times the energy density of batteries. Now, some might say, well, hydrogen combustion efficiency will also improve, which is correct, assuming someone will spend enough resources in research and development of the technology. So, for argument's sake, let's say they get the efficiency all the way up to 50%, which is still overly generous. With that in mind, they will achieve 20,000 watt-hours per kilogram of useful energy in 2035. But here's the thing, batteries don't sit still either, and they are actually moving much faster than hydrogen because of the massive amounts of money spent on research and development. And for good reason, batteries have room for significant improvement, and sometimes we get a breakthrough in battery technology increasing the energy density dramatically. And the next breakthrough is supposed to be solid-state batteries, which have the potential to be 10 times more energy dense than their current lithium-ion counterparts, meaning we could see a battery with 2500 watt-hours per kilogram in energy density before 2035. Which, if you ask me, is quite likely, as we already have solid-state batteries, we just need to figure out manufacturing it. But even with these improvements taken into account, batteries will still be 8 times less energy dense than hydrogen, so it still looks like hydrogen is the best option. But now comes the most critical aspect. price, both the purchasing price of the plane and the price of operating it, which at the end of the day is exactly what it all comes down to, because airlines are running on razor-thin margins. Now, it is pretty difficult to estimate costs for completely new aircraft that we have never seen before and that we don't know the exact size of. So instead of the purchase price, let's talk about the price of hydrogen compared to electricity. And this is where it begins to look pretty dark for hydrogen, as it currently costs $14 per kilogram, and if you compare that to jet fuel that currently costs 83 cents per kilogram, you realize that hydrogen simply wouldn't be viable at all, even if they managed to produce it for 1/15th the price. No airline would ever be able to or want to pay those prices, so hydrogen just isn't viable for them. And there is absolutely no way anyone could be able to produce hydrogen via electrolysis for 1/15th of the current prices. At least that's my estimate. I don't think anyone could do that. So let's compare that to a purely electric plane. Now, 1 kilogram of jet fuel equates to 13 kilowatt hours of energy, which means we need to take the price of 1 kilowatt hour of energy, which in the US is around 11 cents, and multiply that by 13 to come up with the cost for the same amount of energy, which will then be $1.43. That is actually quite a bit higher than the price of jet fuel. But you have to remember that we predicted that these planes would have a 50% efficiency, meaning they only convert 50% of the jet fuel to actual thrust. This means we can actually cut our electricity bill in half, as we don't need to worry about that with an electric plane. That brings us to 70 cents, which compared to kerosene is now 13 cents cheaper for the same amount of useful energy. You could argue an electric plane isn't 100% efficient, which is correct, but they are more than 90% efficient, and putting that into our calculations, electricity will still come out on top. And as fuel prices rise over the coming years and decades, we might see jet fuel increase dramatically in price, as governments also will be putting more taxes on it. And if you compare electricity to hydrogen, which is what we are talking about here, you quickly find out that it would be laughable to do so, even if they managed to cut the prices by 15 times. So hydrogen doesn't make sense when factoring in the cost of hydrogen itself, but it gets even worse than that when you take infrastructure into account. You see, it is vastly more expensive to build out a network of hydrogen refueling stations for planes than it is to build out a charging network. The reason for that is that hydrogen is very energy intensive to produce if you want to do it with electrolysis. And we know the estimated cost of building a hydrogen refueling station for trucks is $20 million for 1600 kilograms of hydrogen per day. And let me tell you, we need a lot more than 1600 kilograms of hydrogen to make these planes fly. I can't even begin to imagine the amount of hydrogen refueling stations we would need at every single airport in the world to make this viable. And it will be up to every single individual airport in the world to choose whether or not they want to build out that infrastructure. And my guess is they won't be doing that anytime soon, as it is so much cheaper to just build out a charging infrastructure for planes instead. The reason is that you already have the electricity at the airport, so you just need to build supercharger stations for planes, which can be built for 1/100th of the price of a refueling station. And why would airports spend so much money on something that is so unlikely to become reality in the first place? And Airbus won't even be able to sell a single plane if there is no place to refuel it. It's that simple. Airbus even stated this on their website. In order to tackle these challenges, airports will require significant hydrogen transport and refueling infrastructure to meet the needs of day-to-day operations. And this begs the question, what airport in their right mind would pay for this infrastructure without a single plane in service that can use it? Well, unfortunately for Airbus, not a single one, unless a bunch of airlines have Airbus's planes on order. Which is unlikely, as by 2035, electric planes will likely be so far in development, it would make no sense to make a sudden shift to hydrogen. Now, why would Airbus make a statement like this that won't have any effect until 15 years in the future? Well, it could be a couple of things, where most prominently it could be shareholders and PR. Shareholders are most likely very interested in where the aviation industry is going and whether or not Airbus has a plan for that. So Airbus came up with these three planes that uses hydrogen combustion to fly. And the thing about hydrogen combustion is that you can practically use the same jet engines that use kerosene, with a few modifications. Airbus could actually make these planes today if they wanted to, and Boeing could do it too, but they choose not to. To me, it seems like they are doing exactly what the car industry has been doing since Tesla entered the market. They give very long-sighted plans for converting their cars to electric, and only realize they have to change rapidly when Tesla is already years ahead of them. It is a lazy and unenthusiastic way of doing things. I don't think Airbus has any interest in making these planes unless Boeing starts doing it before them, or I guess more likely Tesla. I actually made a video on the electric supersonic VTOL plane that Tesla will make eventually, so check that one out and learn what interesting advantages an electric plane will have over all other options. But as for Airbus goes, I am not impressed, and I would love to see Tesla enter this market and catch the duopoly that is Boeing and Airbus off guard. But to clarify, I do think it will take a while before electric planes will be viable for long-haul flights. But if Tesla has 15 years to make that a reality, then I am confident they will make a plane that is vastly better than the hydrogen-powered planes Airbus has proposed. And to be fair, there might be a world in which hydrogen-powered planes will have its place on long-haul flights, where electric planes can't compete until energy densities allow it to. Also, I hope for a sustainable future, and if I'm wrong regarding hydrogen-powered planes, then so be it. If we end up with a sustainable option for flying, then we all win.